Another trip to a dealer, closer to home in Wales, proves an unusual place to rescue an incredible item suffering from years of neglect.
There's an antique shop here based in an old church. I've driven past it more times than I can remember. It's never open. But I know he's open today, so we're going to call in and see what he's got.
But at first sight, buying here could be tricky. Owner Rob Clement bought this former Baptist church 11 years ago and swapped the congregation for curios.
Rob.
Hello. Croeso.
Croeso fi.
Which is... Croeso.
Can we have a look inside?
Of course you may, sir.
Love to. I've been past a few times. But you're never open.
I'm usually fishing.
Blimey. Oh, my word, look at this. Oh, God. Well, you've got a bit of stock in anyway, haven't you?
Yes, people do still complain I'm understocked.
Oh, really?
Yeah, they do.
I've just come into the chapel for the first time, and, well, it's full. Very, very, very full. I think he's got everything in the world that people didn't want. But there has to be something in here. If I can't find something in here today, I'm going to turn around and walk straight out and go and get a real job.
Rob's offering up a piece for Drew's expert attention. It could be buried treasure if it can be linked to prestigious store Liberty, which has traded in London's West End since 1875.
That's what I think is the Liberty piece.
OK.
And it's just a bit of damage on the end there, which is not beyond the wit of man.
How unusual. Yeah. That is incredible, isn't it? Where did you get it from?
I can't not now remember, I'm afraid. I can't.
I recognise the turning on the top of the central leg there.
It's one of the more unusual pieces.
Yeah. I think it's definitely got something, hasn't it? I don't think that carpet's original.
This is getting serious.
Very hard to see in here, isn't it?
Do you want me to... I can't really drag it out anymore, can you?
I think it's got enough plus points going for it. It could be a real rarity.
Mm.
I think I know who it's by, and it's a preeminent...
Really?
Arts and crafts furniture maker, just because of the leg.
This oak bench made in the arts and crafts style is likely to be early 20th century. The arts and crafts movement emerged as a reaction against mass production in the late 1800s, focusing on a return to traditional craftsmanship. Drew suspects the bench could be by renowned arts and crafts designer George Walton. Fully restored, it could be worth £600, but if proved to be by Walton, the value could soar into the thousands.
Is that for sale?
It is, but it's got to be a sensible offer.
OK.
Done up is worth £1,000, £2,000 to a rich American.
I can't see it as £2,000.
Well, I'm
exaggerating a bit. You know what? It might be, because I don't know.
Might be scarce.
It's a tricky one. I've not seen one, ever. And I like it. It's very unusual.
It has the one-off factor that Drew loves, but comes with a dealer's price tag.
So, name your price.
Now, you make me an offer.
600.
650 is yours.
625.
OK.
Deal.
Done.
Thank you. That is a really good start. But I seriously don't know if they're going to get that out.
They'll be fine, we'll get it out.
What's this wheel?
Oh, I will.
Yeah, there you go.
Every now and again in this job, you have to take chances. So I'm taking a £625 gamble on something, and it feels right. And if I'm wrong, I've got a nice bench for the house. If I'm right, we could be quids in.
Hello, hello.
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 Yeah, all right.
Hello, hello.
Hello, hello.
But we bought this.
Oh, it's a two-seater.
Now.
Never seen anything like it.
I've got a feeling I know who it's by, but I need to be sure.
While the bench's origins are being researched, Gavin starts on the restoration. First, he removes the old fabric that wouldn't have been part of the original design. The wood is stained, but he has an unusual way of removing this.
With oil and that, we usually use meths, soak the wood and set it on fire. It burns it out, but I don't know if it'll work with this. It's like a fabric stain. Yeah, that's working.
With the stain removed, the bench is off to French polisher Alex to have the broken back struts repaired.
We can make a paper template of the splat and then transfer it onto a piece of oak and cut it out.
Well, that actually closes it very nicely.
After a sand and a wax, the restoration is barely visible.
Nice, honest repair. Quality, that.
And Drew's gut instinct has proved to be correct.
It was designed by George Walton, incredibly famous designer, made by William Birch of High Wycombe, and retailed through Liberty. So you've got three stellar names there. A rare beast.
With its provenance confirmed, the bench sells to a dealer in America for almost five times what Drew paid for it.